Hey everyone, this is Nick. I'm going to show you two quick and dirty ways to make this really fun icon array chart or waffle chart icon array inside of PowerPoint. So what we're going to do is we're going to go over to my next slide. I have this icon already here. I turned it gray, whatever you want the base color of your chart, of your icon array to be. I recommend that you do that. So I turned it to a nice gray here. And now what I'm going to do is I have downloaded the free Brightside add-in. So you'll want to do that too. Link above and below. Go to brightcarbon.com and check out Brightside. It's very, very cool. If you click on the Brightside tab right there, they have a repeat and distribute button. When you do this, it basically takes one object and it creates many, many copies of that object in a nice row and column sort of format, in a table format. So you can actually set how many miniatures of this one icon that you want. And if I click this, I bet it's going to be 10 and 10. So a row of 10, and column of 10. So right here, you can see I've already done that. So that's what it is. If I wanted another set of numbers, I could do that, enter those numbers here in the box right there. I'm going to go ahead and say okay. So now I have my little waffle chart icon right there. Now remember, I'm just going to drag across the screen, 1, 2, 3, 4 rows right there. I'm going to drag across to select all of them and then go up to the graphics format tab and update the color to this nice deep blue. Now I have 5 more to do, so I can go over here. Just make sure that you're selecting across all of them and that it fill that little selection range that you're doing fills all the borders of the icons. They'll all sort of pop up like that. You can see the little sort of border lines that show up around the icons there. I'm going to go ahead and fill that. And there you go. I got a really cool icon array. If you wanted to move this around like one object, just select everything and push Control G, and that groups everything. And now you can move it around like one chart on the slide. Very, very cool. Now, the other way is a little bit more analog. This does not involve a Brightside add-in. And by the way, if your IT admin is pretty strict, it doesn't matter. Brightside will work. I guarantee you. It'll act like it doesn't, but then you'll close PowerPoint, open it up again, and voila, Brightside will be there. So trust me, go ahead and try it. Anyway, this way is going to be more analog. It's super easy. We're just going to do a lot of copying and pasting, but we're going to use some some keyboard shortcuts. So what we're going to do with our one single icon right there, it's going to be sized exactly how we want it. And now we're going to push. We're not going to do Control C and Control V to paste. We're going to do Control D. D for duplicate. So Control D, it will duplicate this object. I'm going to push Control and D, and there we have the next object. Now I'm going to move this into place, probably right about here. Now I'm not going to do anything else. And when I push Control D again, PowerPoint will be smart and it will know that I want it to be duplicated in exactly the same space, but a little bit over to the right. So let's push Control D and see what happens. There you go. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I just pushed Control D, I guess 9 times to get my row of 10. So in this, I'm going to go ahead and select everything, Control G to group it all. And now I'm going to duplicate this 9 more times. So Control D, I'm going to do that once, and then I'm going to position it exactly the way I want it, probably right there. Look at those red smart guides coming into play, helping me snap this into place. And then I'm going to do Control D for my third row, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And there's my 10 rows. If I want to go ahead and do the whole thing, I'm going to go Control G, and we can move this up. And then if I wanted to make sure to color those, I'm going to do Control-Shift-G to ungroup, Control-Shift-G one more time to ungroup everything else. So now that they're all in their individuals, just like this, and just like last time, I'm going to drag across to select everything, fill those with shapes, or fill those with colors, 5 more, let's see, I think that's 5, and we'll do that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 45% attended a program. Then I would just go ahead and just stylize my slide a little bit more, if I wanted to even like export this slide as an image and post it on social media, something like that. Also a really cool technique, a little cool trick to use for use PowerPoint for. So I love that. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you. Can't wait to see you next time.